Well, this is my first campsite in Colorado. This faint trail here is the Colorado Trail. Just came up a bunch of switchbacks from Lenny's Rest. It was raining pretty good yesterday. I was already pretty tired. It was a long day getting out to Colorado and everything. Beautiful views. Beautiful morning. Now I gotta go down, descent about a mile down to Bear Creek, where I'll be crossing it, following it, crossing it again two more times. To then. Had a good night's sleep, lots of rest, feel pretty good. So last night around 7 in the afternoon, I came here to Lenny's Rest. And I just assumed that the trail went up this way. It's a nice little trail, nice little camp spot right here. Figured it would just keep on going up. So I climbed all the way to the top, which is another 500 feet elevation probably. And then this trail just keeps going. And then I found a nice campsite on the top of the hill. Slept there for the night, packed up. I went down the far side of the hill because the trail just kept going. And it just does the loop like halfway down the trail and comes back up. And so I went all the way down there, did the whole loop, came all the way back up. And I couldn't see any Colorado Trail signs, nowhere, anywhere. There's a couple of campsites up there too. Figured it had to be it. I was looking for a confidence marker. So I came all the way back up to where I camped, and then all the way back here to Lenny's Rest, which in total has been an hour of waste of time this morning. So I got here to Lenny's Rest and instantly seen confidence marker. Had I looked a little more yesterday, I would have noticed it. So I think it just keeps going down this way. So I'm finally back on track. Oh my goodness. And I don't think this can't be it either, because they say bikes are allowed on the trail, and this doesn't look very bike friendly here with this log and the other log there. Probably connects with that Indian trailhead or Indian trail. Anyway, so Lenny's Rest, hang a left and go straight through in here. All right, everybody, so you don't make some stupid mistake like I did and waste the time. All right, now we're descending down to Bear Creek. My goodness. Yeah, this is more like it. The other trail that I was just on that led to the summit of that little mountain. Definitely wasn't, or it was a lot more grown in than this, even on the footpath itself. I knew something wasn't right. I just wanted to find a campsite and then figure it out in the morning. took me a while though. I feel better now. That's great. Beautiful day. It's just overcast. Blue skies over there. It's been like that the whole time, but behind me and to the left over here, it's just nothing but overcast and cloudy. Or I mean dark clouds. Yeah. Whole bunch of wildflowers. Be pretty sweet to be above tree line. Probably won't be for a couple days, but this here is just before Bear Creek. I think it's just a little further down. Look at these beautiful campsites too. It's a really nice one here. Looks like there's some horses here. Maybe there's another one deep and down in there. Here's another really nice one. Damn it. Yeah, if it hadn't been raining yesterday, I would have for sure spent the night here. Somebody leaving garbage again. It's always sad to see. Here's Little Bear Creek. Looks like nice, clean, fresh water too. Filter it, fill up all my bottles. It's the last water, a reliable water source for 8.1 miles. The trail's a little bit growing in here. Looks nice. Just wish all this foliage wasn't so wet. Oh, I hope the sun comes out and stays out. That would make my day. Dry up my shoes a little. They are just absolutely drenched. Squishy, squishy inside my shoe. This is mile 8.7, crossing Bear Creek right now. Just a couple of rocks here. Step over. Well, we just passed or crossed Bear Creek. And on this side of Bear Creek, there's another really nice camp spot, and I think there might be another one down there. So, there's about three campsites on that side of Bear Creek, and another one or two on this side. Sure, you could make another one or something too. Had I known this last night. Well, I just passed Devin and Dave, the guys that I met in the beginning of the trailhead yesterday. And they're biking the entire CT Colorado Trail. And they're still at their campsite. I'm just gonna see if they could get everything to dry up before they headed out. I had quite a storm last night. I think I must have slept through it a lot because these guys were saying it was just absolutely insane. Like so much rain and thunder, lightning and everything. I remember rain, but a little bit of lightning, a little bit of thunder. but nothing like what they were talking about. So glad I camped where I did, even though it was way off track. So I didn't get too wet yesterday before the storm came. It was raining a little bit before I, or while I was setting up my tent. And the entire time I was making food, and pretty much until I went to bed. But yep. After crossing Bear Creek, the trail takes an ascent of 1,400 feet. To a high point on segment one. So I got a fair little bit of climbing to do now. It'll be the highest I've been ever, I think. So a little over 7,000 feet at the high point. Well, I just ran into, his name was Timber, and it's not even his trail name, it's his real name. And he had a dog with him, and they were coming from Durango, and they were planning on finishing today. So that was pretty sweet. And he gave me a bunch of information on campsites and water spots and what to look for. And he said he's seen a couple of moose up here too, and some really colorful birds. And he told me to stay at that yurt in segment 23, 24. I forget now what kind of he said. And I guess the burn area is really dry, and there's lots of really nice campsites coming up. So that was really neat running into him. Gave me a lot of information. Oh, yeah, good for him though. He's finishing today. Said it was just like yesterday he started, and now he's pretty much done. He did the Collegiate West as well, which I'm doing. I'm actually going to do the Collegiate Peaks Loop. And said that was just absolutely beautiful. Hiked with a lot of CT, or Continental Divide Trail through hikers, doing about 20 miles a day. And he said that there's a quite a few people going from Denver to Durango. He must have passed at least maybe 24. And there was another guy that's just a little bit ahead of me now. So probably end up hiking with some people, yeah. Which is gonna be pretty neat, I'm sure. I love the solitude though. I really do. Being out here all alone, with your own thoughts and your own pace. Absolutely love it. Take as many photos as I want and videos and stop and do whatever I feel. Oh man. It's turning out to be a beautiful day. Some clouds out. So happy I'm here. Body feels great. Pack is a little heavy. Just filled up water there at Bear Creek. So there's another creek coming up, South Plateau or something. So that was the last one in 10 miles. That was the last water source in 10 miles through the dry burn area. So he said that dry burn area was really neat too. You could see everything. So far, like a long distance. Yeah, I've been meeting all kinds of people out here. It's nice. And everyone's so friendly too. No one's really commented on my big pack yet. I'm sure somebody will. took my shoes off, my socks, took the insoles out of my shoes. It's all drying right now, so hopefully when I get back on the trail, I have dry feet. That'll be really comfortable. My second skin came off with it being so darn wet. Oh my goodness, what a view. Colorado. Yeah, this must be leaning rocks. What the fuck? What kind of moron leaves out there? Oh my goodness. You see it punched. Punched real good. We don't have that shit out here. Charging my cell phone. Beautiful sunny day. Here's my shoes and socks. Insoles. Dave and Devin just came by here. They hung out here a little while too. Yeah, climbing these with the bicycle, wow. You'd have to be in pretty good shape. My left knee is giving me a little bit of pain. I don't know what's going on. It's not bad. It's kind of more irritating than pain, I guess. All the way down on these switchbacks. What a beautiful trail. I think that's that big burn area. It's that clearing spot right there. Walk through that today yet. Left my pack down by the trail. Thought I'd come and scramble up these rocks. Take a view at this. Take a look at this view. Wow, we're a lot closer to the burn area already. Must be the Plateau, South Plateau River. Last water source for 10 miles. 10 miles through the burn area. Wow. Just doesn't stop. Endless mountains. That's the Colorado Trail right there. going. I gotta head out all, head down all the way to that river. Oh, there it is. Pretty big bridge. You get some water there. Go through the burn area. We're getting closer and closer to the river. In the burn area. Just right up in the center there. Wow, that must have been a pretty good fire. I just ran into Bob again, and he told me that that peak over there was long scraggy peak, and the one over here, it's a little bit behind here, that peak over there is Raleigh Peak, long scraggy peak. Scraggly peak or scraggy, yeah. And the river and the bridge is just down there. Said cross that river, and then you gotta turn right and then underneath it again. And just follow that river. All right, I'm really close to the river now. And here's another really nice camp spot. It's only about 3:30 right now. Or I would take it. Really nice. That's just before the river. You can actually see the river and the road right there. Nice flat area. I just got off the bridge, went under the bridge, came over here to this first little walkway to the river, and filled up both my Nalgenes, and I put a liter into my water bag and my backpack. Alright, segment one is done. Off to segment two. Segment two is only 11 miles, so that's all right. One down, 27 to go. All right, the next 5 miles, I'm doing 1,000, probably 1,600 or so. Feet elevation. So it's all up now. This looks like some no man's land.
some old mining roads there. I'm gonna check where this leads to. Some old mining equipment. Old truck. Well, it's really unfortunate that all these trees got burnt down, but sure is beautiful though. It's been really nice walking through here. Not a drop of shade though. Sun's been out the whole time. Hasn't even really looked like it was gonna rain even today. It's been absolutely beautiful, beautiful day. Couldn't ask for better hiking anyway. I think it won't be too long now and I'll be in the trees again. Well, it looks to me like we're out of the burn area. Lots of shade here again. Lots of trees. Still climbing though. Oh my goodness. Well, since I crossed that Gudy's bridge, I'm pushing myself pretty hard. I think it's about time to stop and eat. See how I feel. Maybe we could do another mile or two after I eat. Sure is nice though still. So happy it's not, we didn't have those afternoon thunderstorms.